teardrop. Go to your shapes and look for a triangle up shape and add it to your design. Somehow change the color and make the color this beautiful gradient blue color, and then just make it tiny bit smaller, and then use your border styles to create a corner rounding shape, just a little bit, like a 10. Then add a circle. You can also press C for circle. Change the shape to that gradient blue color of ours, and then reduce the size and align it to our triangle so that it looks like teardrop. Group the two shapes and then duplicate the group. The second group, we change the color and we make that white. Grab the white group, add it to the blue group, and then reduce the size slightly so that you create a line. You want a beautiful thin line. With me zooming in, I can see that there's a little bump on our line. I don't like that. So what you would do, you would ungroup the group and then adjust the lines. Make that a little bit bigger so that the line disappears, and just adjust it so that it exactly smooth and it looks like the counterpart on the right hand side. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do, and now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. Once you fix that bump, we're gonna download this image as a transparent background. If you don't have transparent background, you can trial it with my link below. And when it's downloaded and we're happy, I don't like deleting my work, because what if I need it? You can add an extra page, page 2, and then you can add the downloaded symbol back to Canva. As you clearly see, it still has that white shape in there. So we're going to click on edit image, and we're going to use the old background remover from the old photo editor and remove the inside of our teardrop. Lovely. We click on apply and we double check if it's definitely gone. It's gone. So we're going to select the image, reduce the size of the image, and take off the extra space. And there's our gorgeous teardrop nicely created. Now we're going to start zooming in and we're going to create the symbol. We're going to duplicate this shape, move it and align it to the first teardrops, rotate it slightly, and start creating your symbol. And then duplicate the shape and do exactly the same. No, it's easier to hide and just to lay low. Not everyone in life has got a halo. I'm standing in the red inside a payphone. Just wanna break, no. I'm not gonna give in. Take a last shot, Michael J. Wynn. No, I'm not a robot, I'm in my own skin. Never get lost when thoughts pull you in. I miss the old you. We died with a purpose. All the energy around me felt nervous. Scared I would pop out fast to the surface. Had to cut it off before you made me worthless. Torn apart, I've been torn and scarred. I had a given art, but now I'm thinking smart. I'm keeping up my guard. I'm hiding every card. A royal flush of love. You never know what's hard. With a back to the mat, gonna see where I'm at. I'ma fight like I'm mad. I'ma be something that they can never be me. Nice try, but they'll see I achieve everything while they stay salty. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do, and now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's... Let me know in the comments below what you think of this one. We're going to convert it real quick using Photopea. So you're gonna download the second page as a transparent background. Once you've picked your mockup, click on the link to open it up and double click where it says your logo here, and it has a group, so don't hide everything because there's a group. Click on the drop down arrow so that it opens up the group for us. Then we can hide the text and we can hide the example that the designer has given to us. Then we drag our 2D logo and we size it and align it. Then we press Command S to convert it to smart object. And then we click on the first link that says 3D logo mockup. And there's your symbol logo, done and dusted,
gorgeously created. This is not the only way you could do it. You could go on Canva as well and convert it to different kinds of mockups that you could use for your design. Thank you so much for joining me on this video. Let me know in the comments below if this has added value. For more ideas, please go to our playlist. I will see you on the next video.